Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm doing pretty well, and I'm excited because another demo now I get to share with you that has come to us through our community. In this case, through our Facebook community supporting Evernote Made Easy, our course on getting more out of Evernote. Some of the users there, some of the members there, have told me about a new app called Swipes, which they quite liked. Now, we've done a lot on task managers, and Swipes is definitely a task manager. Primarily in the past, we've looked at team-based task managers, and we liked apps like Asana and Trello and Todoist. But we've never really focused in on an individual task manager that we really like. We like Wunderlist. It's a good one, but there's still a place out there, I think, for a really good solo task manager. Now, I'm not sure Swipes was exactly designed to be a solo task manager, but it does work very well in the individual, at least in at first blush, for individuals. But the real magic behind it is its really deep integration with Evernote. So today, task managers for individuals that want to integrate with Evernote on Dotto Tech. Now, Swipes, I'm still fairly new in using Swipes, but my initial reaction, response to it is pretty darn positive. If you take a look at the website, you get a feel for what Swipes is all about. But essentially, it's a task and to-do list manager that you do most of your work in Evernote. You create all of your tasks and to-dos in Evernote and use the checkbox features in Evernote, and I'll show you that in a few minutes, in order to create the items within a task. And if we take a look quickly through their website. Currently, the app's available for free, and it's available iPhone, iPad, Android, and a web-based version. So you've got some nice options as far as your platform for delivery. The rest of their site is pretty polished, looks great, but really, in order to figure out the app, we should just dive into it. Now, if you want to understand the integration with Evernote, how we set it up to integrate with Evernote, stick around. At the end of this video, I'll set it up for you. So I'm going to wait. We'll go right through to the very end of the video, and then if you stick around to the very, very end, after the normal end, you can see I walked through the actual integration, in case that's something that you happen to be interested in, but I didn't want to waste main demo time for that. Now, when we set up Swipes, when we look at Swipes, let's open it up here. Basically, you've got tasks, and within tasks, you have action steps, and you create those in Evernote. You can create them in the app itself, but really, for our purposes, we're most interested in how this all works within Evernote. So, if you create a new task from scratch, what happens is when you create an Evernote note, as I've done here, and the title of that note becomes the task in Swipes that we will see. And then you can add whatever text you want to the note, because the entire note comes into Swipes, but every time you create a check mark within the task, that becomes an action step in Swipes that you can then work with. So, and then how you actually assign that note to going into Swipes, because you don't want all of your Evernotes appearing in Swipes. You then apply the tag, which you see I've done right here at the very top. You create a tag that says Swipes. When you do that, it takes a few seconds for it to sync between the different services, but all of a sudden the note appears. And here you can see it in my on my iPhone in Swipes. The title becomes a task. So there's the task that I just worked on. And now if I open that task up, we can see I have task one and all of the action steps. If I tap here, I can see all of the action steps. Now, all of the text does not appear to show up in the task list. Only the things that are behind, if we take a look here, only the things that are behind the behind check marks. But it's a two-way communication happening. So if I then say take task one here, I tap on task one, and if I swipe to the right, I can mark it as done. Now next time it's synced back to the computer, it should appear on the computer as checked off. Let's add another action step here just so that we can see the integration happen completely, and it will say stuff. We'll make this stuff because it's so important. We'll make this stuff. And then say done. And so we've just added an action step. So I'm going to go back into Swipes here itself, and I'm going to kind of force an update. So if I click here on the very bottom on the little dots, if I click on the gear icon, you can see the management console for swipes. And I'm going to just click on sync here to force a sync. And I'm going to do the same on my computer just so that we can see that that note that we've just done, there it is. It's already got it happened here. So the little check mark happens here saying the task is done and we've added a new item to it. Now there's lots more to this app. Of course, we can snooze tasks. We can do a variety of different other things with the tasks. If we tap on the integrations area, we can see how it links to Evernote. Now currently it's only going to bring in notes that have that are tagged swipes, but you can also import other notes. You can actually open the Evernote note importer and it'll give you a complete list of all of your notes, and you can import some of those notes even if they aren't tagged into swipes so that you can turn them into tasks with action items as well. But I think if you're just using it this way here, where you're using the checkboxes to create action items within tasks, understanding that the title is the task, that you've got a pretty effective integrated task manager. It's not as robust, it's not as complex as far as is creating almost project management type work as we have, say, in an Asana or in a Trello or in Todoist. But as a way of managing simple tasks within Evernote, exporting them out and getting them into our mobile devices where we can have access to them as we need to do those tasks, it looks like it's got some really nice things going for it. So that's it for this. A quick little introduction to swipes. If you want to stick around to the very end, after the credits, you will be able to see the integration, how I actually set up the first integration. And I hope that you found this video today to be useful. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. The second is subscribe to our newsletter so you can hear about all of our live webinars and events that we have coming up, as well as get a weekly digest of all of the different videos that we post here on the channel. And finally, Dotto Tech is supported by the community through Patreon. If you drop by and take a look at our Patreon page, you will discover what it's like to become a community member of Dotto Tech. And if you do decide to become a member of our community, what perks are included for you? That is it for today. I am Steve Dotto. Till next time, have fun storming a castle. I've just started playing with swipe, so let's see what we can do. By hitting the three little dots down at the bottom of the screen, we can get into our settings, and here we can set up integrations right there. Set up integrations. And the whole idea is to link the account, obviously, with our Evernote account. So that's really the, as far as I'm concerned, the key to any app like this is how is it going to integrate with Evernote? Because Evernote is where everything lives. So I'll just go through the authorization process and then we'll see how it integrates with Evernote. So it has now connected with Evernote. So it's allowing me here now to choose notes to connect to swipes. So imagine what's happening is it's going to be taking, so you're going to want to create a to-do list in Evernote, and that to-do list will refer, otherwise everything you put checkboxes or make into to-dos on Evernote is going to come through. So I'm just going to choose this one that I call here Important Meetings. I'm just going to import the OneNote. That's actually a demo document that I set up. So let's take a look at the settings here. Sync with Evernote on this device. Import notes with the swipes tag. So we have to create a swipes tag. That's going to be straightforward. Sync with personal link notebooks, yes. Sync with Evernote for Business. Tap to learn more. And that's for work group environment, so we don't really need that right now. So let's just go back to swipes. There it is. And open the Evernote importer, which we're just looking at. So we're done. So we can now close this down, and we should be able to go in, hit sync, and there's the important meeting note. So let's dive into it a bit now. We've got it set up on the smartphone. Let's figure things out on the Evernote side.